everyone, as promised, I'm here to give a little bit of a comparison between the Lego and Mega Construx versions of brick-built Fender Stratocasters. Now, these are both officially licensed products, licensed with Fender itself. The Mega Construx one came out, I believe it was early spring 2021, and the Lego one was just released within the past week from the recording of this video here. I got this on Amazon myself in mid-spring for $50 US. That was its retail price. And the Lego one is $100 US, but also comes with an amp. However, the two of these things are shockingly close in size. I was really surprised to see that. They are done to the same scale. I really wonder what happened behind the scenes with the licensor in particular. How much of this they planned, what exactly their feeling was behind the scenes on getting these things out to market, because the way that it started out was through a contest on the Lego Ideas platform, and this one won that contest for a specific theme of music and musical instruments. And then Lego took that design and completely redid it, rebuilt it to their own standards, and came up with this full set, which, you know, took quite some time to do. Meanwhile, Mega Construx was already able to get theirs out. Now, these do take rather different approaches, and a lot of people will not agree on one or the other. And unfortunately, a lot of people just get into these very rigid camps. I'm not going to try to support that myself. I like to have an open mind. I like to look at these as just plastic toys or plastic display pieces made of toy brick pieces. And I think that they're both cool. A lot of people will automatically be biased in one direction or another. I try to leave as much of that bias out as possible. After all, Mega Construx, yes, did start out as a clone brand, a fully legal clone brand of Lego after their patents expired in the early 1990s. But on the other hand, Lego also started out as a clone brand, cloning Kittycraft bricks for their first decade of doing these products. So when it comes to ethical dilemmas and everything, I like to just push all that aside and let's just look at these as they are. To me, as someone who doesn't have a lot of domain expertise here, I don't play guitar and I am not a Fender history scholar or anything like that, but at first glance, this looks more accurate to me. The Mega Construx one looks more accurate, and part of that is because they did spend the extra budget to make more specialized pieces specifically for it, and also Mega has more non-specialized pieces that they use throughout their entire line, such as different shapes and sizes of slopes and curve pieces. And I think that they ended up just capturing the look of the source material a little bit better. That said, of course, Lego did an excellent job. Their designers are quite good at what they do. Did an excellent job with the pieces that are available in the Lego palette, I think. And Lego did use some specialized prints over here for the pickups, for the entire fretboard, and also the Fender logo up top. But Mega Construx went further with even more prints for more of the small details. The closer up you get, the more that becomes apparent, and to my eyes, the Lego one feels more like a brick-built thing. It feels more like a traditional Lego or Lego style of build, because indeed it is, although they did introduce a new piece just this year, specifically for one of the curves that they wanted to get in there. It's used up here and also over here, but they will use that piece for other sets. And as a matter of fact, they've already shown it on one of the new sets more recently revealed. But this just feels a little bit more like a static plastic model to me, for better or worse, right? Some people appreciate this sort of adherence to reality, and, you know, the inclusion of specialized pieces like this, and those specialized prints that they brought in there, and the entire pick guard that's done as its own separate piece. More importantly, when you get up to the neck, you get all the way up to the head, there's a lot of specialized part usage, including all of that right there being mostly one piece in order to get the shaping that they specifically wanted to go for. And that's what they wanted to do. That was by design. It's not because they can't do it the way that Lego did it. This is what they chose. and I think that it ends up looking better, but it's not as interesting of a build experience. Both of them have the experience of stringing up the guitar, which felt good. They used different types of material between the two, but they both felt good to me and interesting and a little bit intricate. And it's just different. Between the two, I think that Lego has a little bit better color matching from part to part, but they do have some pieces that are disappointingly noticeably different, like those larger parts for these corners here are noticeably darker. And from what I've heard, some people have gotten even more variety than that, which is not what you want to see for a premium product. But you come over to the Mega Construx side, and I think that they're even worse. Neither is good, but this one is not as good in terms of the quality and consistency just for the regular parts. When it comes to extras, beyond the minimum stuff required for the guitar, you get a faux mother of pearl pick here, which, as I understand it, is a real a real pick that you can use on a real guitar over here. Those are very, you know, cheap and mass produced and everything. And you also get a stand from the Mega Construx side, which itself can fold up and be stored away easily. Forgot to show this around the back. This also has some additional prints back there. But the Lego one does not have a pick. Well, they include some tiny little pieces that represent picks, but more importantly, they have this strap, which is nice. And this has value. It's done with quality, and it's done with reverence to both brands, to Fender itself and to Lego. I think that's really cool. And I think that the Lego stand is much better. It is thicker, it's stronger, it holds the guitar a little bit better, and also is able to fold up for storage if you need. This right here is a sticker on the back of the Lego one, and there's nothing done in the center. And then all along the back here, you can see more of the construction of how it's put together with just so-called regular pieces. We're still looking at $50 versus $100 though, and to help explain that difference in price, the Lego one also includes this extra bag of parts plus one other to allow you to alternately build the body in black. It's literally all the pieces that you need to build the entire body purely in black with no hybridization in between. That is a nice addition, you know, and those parts have value. If you don't want to ever build it in one of the colors, then those parts are basically just yours to keep. And also, of course, most importantly, the Lego one comes with the amp. And I think that most of the additional value from the Lego one is in that amp, which myself and many people actually like even better than the guitar itself on the Lego version. This just looks really, really good from the outside. And then you open it up and it's got like circuitry inside. You can see all the details in my review and the official pictures and everything, but they have details on the inside from the back as well. And this is kind of next level. You know, it really kicks it up a notch, and I feel definitely makes it feel like we're not looking at a simple difference of quality of parts and then Lego having the bigger brand and being able to sell a lot better, having the bigger marketing machine, which allows them to charge more. No, you really do get a lot more with this. It also has a pedal over here and additional line that you can connect right up to the guitar itself, even though some of those details are not as accurate, again, as on the Mega model. I think that that Lego has given you a much more complete product over here. There is one other thing, though, that Mega does include that Lego does not, and that is this box. This is the original box that the product comes in. It has a sleeve over it as well that you just remove, and then you open it up, and it's kind of deluxe inside. You can also use this as a storage case for the guitar, and it, you know, kind of looks semi-realistic. It's nice enough for display, and, you know, if you don't want to have the thing out all the time, you don't want to have it collecting dust. I don't know, I mean, I just think it's nice even to have this packaging. I'm not a big fan of packaging in general, but Mega has done some really nice stuff in the past with some of their more premium specialized products, and this definitely counts. And I think this adds a little bit of value to their product here, even though it is just packaging. There is some value here. But all in all, I feel like between these two, Lego solidly wins. If there has to be a winner between the two, I think Lego would have won even more strongly and soundly if they had offered this as just a $50 guitar kit. You know, they could have sold it just as a $50 guitar kit with just the guitar and the stand, and then offered up all the other stuff as an add-on, an optional add-on. Regardless, overall here, I think that Mega did a good job. They have a different way of designing things. They worked with Fender just like Lego did. They were more willing to do more specialized pieces here and more prints, which is good. I think that there's value there. I think that a lot of people will appreciate just how good this looks, how accurate this looks. A lot of other people will appreciate the fact that this does not use as many specialized pieces. So I think there's value on both sides for that, and it's gonna just come down to individual preference. But myself, I'm glad that I got both. I'm glad that I was able to do this comparison, and I'm surprised that I don't have a strong feeling, a strong leaning towards one or the other. I thought I was really gonna lean in favor of the Mega Construx one because of how good it looks, and you know, it's a pretty dang good build, and I really like that packaging as well. But Lego over here with the strap, I don't know why I like the strap so much, but the amp, yeah, twice as much, but I think it's worth it. Let me know what you think down in the comments. Just keep it civil, please, and I'll talk to you again soon.